Hi YouTube, and welcome to my channel. I would first like to apologize in advance for my bad English. It's not my first language, and I also have a little bit of a speech impediment. But I hope that you still can understand what I'm saying. In this video, I will be talking about something called push-off. I see this subject popping up on various forums from time to time, but I have not found a video that explains exactly what push-off is, and what causes it, and how to fix it. And the timing is just perfect because I got this Smith Wesson model 629 in from a customer the other day because he did a trigger job on it himself. So this here, I can now show you what push-off is. Push-off is when you can cock the hammer to single action, and when you use force push on the back of the hammer, the hammer, it will fall. And as you can see, I have no finger on the trigger, but I can push like that and it will fall. And this here is a very bad trigger job, because if you look at the trigger, I'm not using any force at all, like that. And I can show you what causes push-off and how to fix it. So just bear with me while I remove the side plates. So now I have removed the side plate, so you can see what happens inside the mechanism. And like I said, I have already moved the hand. It was supposed to be attached there. The hand is what makes the cylinder turn around. So on the trigger, you have the sear nose. That is this part here. And on the hammer, you have the sear notch that is on top, that is just right there. So what will happen when you cock the hammer? You see, right now the sear nose, it is engaged with the sear notch. Both the angles on the sear notch and the sear nose, they are precision made. And when you start altering the angles on either part, it will also affect the trigger. In this case, the owner, he altered the angles on the sear nose, and he altered the angles that is on the sear notch. So what will happen is that you have push-off, pushing on back of the hammer, it will release. And in this case here, make sure that everything is tight, and you see almost no pressure on the trigger, like that. So I have now removed the parts from the revolver, and like I mentioned, on the hammer, you have the sear notch that is located right there. I don't know if you can see it, but there's a little bit of a notch there. And that notch, it is machined to within thousands of an inch. And if you start stoning this portion here of the hammer, and you remove material or you alter the angles on them, you basically have destroyed the hammer. It cannot be saved if you take off too much material. You just need to buy a new hammer. What you usually will do in a trigger job when you want to lighten the single action pull, you only do this here to the sear nose that you have right there, this portion here. And this here, it has a specific angle that interacts with the sear notch. And what you usually will do on a trigger job, it is that you take a stone and just drag it on top of the nose there. You start to round it off. And the good thing about only stoning the sear nose, it is that if you round it off too much, you can fix it again. You can make this portion of the trigger sharp again. And I'll show you that right now. Okay, I will now show you how to fix push-off. If the only thing that have been stoned was the sear nose, and if there has not been removed too much material. When performing a trigger job, you basically take the stone like this here, straight over it, to round it off. But to fix it, it is very simple. You just have the stone like this here, and the other end of the stone just resting on the table like this here. And you just do like this here. You will now get the proper angle and sharpen the sear nose. And it's basically just do like this here until you have fixed the problem. Now I have put the revolver back together with factory new parts. As you can see, no push off and a normal single action trigger. In this case here, the push off, it was caused by the owner doing a trigger job on it. He over polished the parts and removed too much material. I probably could have fixed this here by stoning the sear nose, like the way I showed you. But the owner, he over polished the parts and removed too much material. So the only fix for this here, it was new parts. I have read on a couple of forums that are saying the cause for push-off, it is a worn mainspring, and that you can fix push-off with only replacing it with a new mainspring, or that you use a much more heavier mainspring. That is not true. The only cause to push-off, it is either done by somebody altering the angles on the sear nose or the sear notch, either by stoning or by heavy use. I have been working with Smith Wesson revolvers for 5 or 6 years now, and I have not yet seen an old revolver with push-off that has seen lots of use. The only revolvers I've seen with push-off, it is because it has been performed a trigger job on them. So I have now showed you what causes push-off and how you might fix it. And I hope that you have enjoyed the video and that you learned something new. I appreciate any comments on what I could have done better. And if you have liked the video, please press the like button. And if you know of any other way to fix push-off, please mention so in the comments. I would much appreciate it.